If you've been around poker strategy for a while, chances are you've heard good players say something like, our range has more equity here, and as such we should be betting at a high frequency. Or in another spot, maybe villain's range has more equity, and as such we should be checking here a decent chunk of the time. And while these statements may sound smart and logical, and sometimes might be true, equity is not the entire name of the game when it comes to poker strategy and GTO specifically. Today I'm going to talk about what you should be focusing on instead. Let's get into it. Good morning. How are we doing today? My name is James Sweeney, aka SplitSuit, and today we need to have a conversation about equity. Now, just in case you made it to this video but don't have a good working definition of what equity is, let's quickly define it. Equity, or pot equity, refers to how often a hand or range can expect to win a showdown if there is no further betting action. It's oftentimes thought of as a player's rightful share of the current pot based upon the strength of their own hand or range. Now, equity is not something that you're going to be precisely calculating in real time, but when you're studying hands between sessions, you can use tools like Equilab or Poker Cruncher or Flopzilla Pro and get these sort of numbers very, very easily when you plug in your hand or your range against your opponent's hand or range. Now, for years and years, if not decades and decades, players have been using equity as the linchpin of their entire poker strategy. Have more equity, fire. Have a ton more equity, fire big. And while these things may sound okay, they fall apart pretty darn quickly, and solvers have definitely started to show this very, very easily. So take one of the comments that we looked at earlier, right? Take a spot where we have more equity than our opponent does, and you might think, okay, well, we should be betting at a high frequency here. Sometimes this is true, but this is not a universal truth, and it's pretty easy to disprove it. And for what it's worth, things become even more problematic when people try to base their entire sizing strategy based upon equity as well. These kind of things fall apart very, very quickly when you start doing any sort of analysis and playing with GTO models. So if you take nothing else away from this video, at least take this. It is impossible to determine a GTO strategy if we only know our pot equity. And if you don't believe me, let's do a little experiment. Imagine for a moment that you're in a spot and your range has roughly 50% pot equity against your opponent's range. Well, it might seem like this gives you a lot of information about how the ranges stack up, but actually it tells you almost nothing. And we can visualize this by thinking about a few different ways that we could possibly have exactly 50% equity. So take spot number one. Player one and player two both have the exact same range. In that spot, they're of course both going to have 50% equity. Or another spot where player one has the top 50% of hands, which have 100% equity, while the bottom 50% of their range have 0% equity against player two. And in that same spot, player two has exactly 50% equity against player one's entire range. Every hand in their range has again 50% equity against player one's. So both players again would have 50% equity exactly in this spot. Or how about a third scenario, where player one has a random selection of hands that just so happen to have exactly 50% equity against player two's range, while player 2 has a random selection of hands that just so happen to have exactly 50% equity against player 1's range. Again, in all three of these scenarios, both players have exactly 50% equity against each other. And of course, you can definitely come up with other examples in different varieties and scenarios where this exact same statement can be true. Now, if pot equity actually mattered when it came to determining our betting strategy, we would expect to see a similar overall strategy being employed across all three of those different scenarios we just looked at. But what we actually see is a solver employs very different strategies depending on the exact details of each scenario. And this is because a GTO strategy is not so much based upon how much equity a range has, but rather how the equity is distributed. Now, if you've never heard of this term before, equity distribution refers to how equity is distributed across a range in comparison to another range. So you can have an equity distribution graph, which is a visual representation of the equities of hands in two competing ranges. So it does so by measuring the equity of every single hand in range one versus the entirety of range 2 and vice versa. Now, if you've never seen an equity distribution graph before, they're pretty simple once you've looked at enough of them and kind of get a general feel for what's going on. But if we look at a very basic one, we have location and range at the bottom. So we look at the strongest hands in a player's range all the way down to the weakest hands in their range. And then we have the overall equity from 0 to 100%. And then we just compare those two ranges right there on the same graph. Now, some GTO solvers will have equity distribution graphs baked right into them. Others might have to do a little bit of work. So for instance, if you're using GTO Plus, you can look at the overall equity for your specific hand or range that you're analyzing by clicking that button right down there when you're in a particular spot. So if you want to look at the equity distribution for all your bets, you can do that very simply, but that's just looking at one person's range. If you want to look at both of them, you can very simply go to Flopzilla Pro up at the top, export to Flopzilla Pro, open it up there, and then you can look at the equity graph right here. So you see the person we're analyzing is in the highlighted blue, and then the other player is that duller green right behind. And if you were to switch the players right here, then of course those colors just invert, so you know which one you're focusing on. The bright color is the one you're looking at. The other person is the villain in that particular spot. And you can see again what happens in these different ranges. So at the strongest of the hands right up here, where the equity is 100% for the player we're analyzing, of course they have deuces, so quads right that moment, and you can see how the equities are distributed across the entire way. So you notice that around, 75-ish% of the way through the distribution, all of a sudden the equity plummets massively, and all of a sudden we're in bluff mode for the opponent we're looking at right this moment. Well, the other player, that green line, is staying a little bit more steady, and all of a sudden in the tail end of the range, they are doing much, much better than the aggressor right this moment. So hopefully that makes sense. And again, the more you look at these, the more you're going to get a general feel for how you can actually analyze these and what you should be strategically taking away from them. Now, if we just stay here on this graph for a moment, we don't get lost in any like minutia or precise details. We're not going to look at the specific board texture. We're not going to look at the specific bet size on the river or anything like that. We're just going to look at the graph itself and see what else we can dig out of it. What you see is this very common pattern where one equity line is going to start higher up on the left side of the graph and then vertically intersect with the second line, finishing up in the lower right-hand corner. This again is another example of a pair of polarized and condensed ranges. Very, very common setup, usually where the polarized range is the aggressor and the condensed range is going to be more of the defender in that particular spot. But there are two major things that you want to note from this. One is that notice the value hands in the aggressor's range are not going to have 100% equity against their opponent. This is very, very common, but a lot of people don't necessarily always remember it. And then number two is thinking about the nutted equity distribution. So we notice that the aggressor's range starts higher up in that top left-hand corner. That's because their range contains hands that the defender cannot currently beat. And since this particular spot is a river spot, they're never going to be able to beat it because, again, it's the river. There's no more future cards coming out. And this is a very important principle in GTO poker, and you have to understand it, and that is nutted equity distribution. So a range is said to have the nutted equity distribution when it contains hands that are so strong that the other range can never beat them, at least not without additional cards being dealt. So for instance, if player one has pocket kings and pocket queens in the range and the board is king, queen, five, and player two cannot have those hands, then we say that player one has the nutted equity distribution. So in the particular graph we're looking at right this moment, notice again, quads can only be had by one of the players, and of course that has 100% equity based upon the way it's all settled down. Now all these terms and concepts don't 100% of the time mean that you should always bet or never bet, or that you should always choose a large size or never choose a large size. Rather, they all bend directly into a concept called range advantage. And I did a full video on that you can watch right there. I would highly suggest watching that next, and that will kind of start to tie all of this stuff together and help you make a little bit more sense of these concepts and what to do with them strategically. So watch that video next. I hope you enjoy it. If you have any comments or questions, hopefully this helps you again understand, if nothing else, a pure pot equity strategy is not what you're looking for. Instead, you need these overall terms and concepts that really help you put everything together. And again, equity distribution is infinitely more important. Again, go watch that video on range advantage next. See you over there shortly. And in the meantime, good luck out there and happy grinding.